Okay, good morning friends. So we continue our previous topic, that is the polar radiations. So today we start with a Nicolpix. Basically, Nicolpix is nothing but it's a one device which converts unpolarized light into a polarized light. So I can say Nicolpix. Nicolpix is a device which converts unpolarized light. Polarized light. Basically, it works on the principle of double refraction. Already we discussed the double refraction. So, very first, it was designed by William Nicol in 1820. A Nicolpix is made of a calcite crystal. Calcite crystals, we made a Nicolpix prism by using the calcite crystal. We cut a calcite crystal in such a manner that it produces a double reflection. We can say Nicolpix is a one kind of polarizer and used to generate a beam of polarized light. Right? It has a rhombohedral crystal. The structure of the Nicolpix is a rhombohedral of a calcite which is cut at an angle of 68 degrees. It splits diagonally and joins again by the one kind of cement that is called the Kerner balsam. So now I draw the Nicolpix. So basically it's a rhombohedral crystal. So it's a rhombohedral calcite crystal. This is a calcite crystal, calcium carbonate. Calcite crystal. It's a rhombohedral structure and the angle is 68 degrees. This angle is 68 degrees. Now, unpolarized light is incident on a one surface of a Nicol prism and due to double refraction, it splits into the two parts. One is E ray and another is O ray. So, basically, it splits here. It is nothing but we previously cut this calcite crystal into the two parts and finally again we joined by a one kind of cement that is known as the Kerner balsam. So by using the Kerner balsam we joined it. The refractive index of the Kerner balsam is mu is equal to 1.55. It's a transparent material, Kerner balsam. So this layer represents the Kerner balsam. So we joined these two parts using the Kerner balsam. So now this part has a different refractive index. This part is different refractive index. That's why it splits the unpolarized light into the two parts. So when this unpolarized light incident here, one of the rays can easily transmit through this Nicolpix, while other one is reflected and come out from this surface. This ray is known as E ray, while this is the ray is O ray. So we split unpolarized light into the two parts, one is E ray, another is O ray. O again we already discussed, it's an ordinary ray which follows the Snell law, while E is the extraordinary ray which doesn't follow the Snell law. So if we rotate this calcite crystal or this Nicolpix, this E ray will be fixed while O is rotating around this E. So this is the diagram of a Nicolpix which is used for finding the polarized light. Next, wave plates again are made by a calcite crystal and it is used to change the state of polarization of incident wave, and these are the two types. Basically, one is known as the quarter wave plate and another is the half wave plate. So these are wave plates. Which is used to change the state of polarization of incident wave. So, very first I consider quarter wave plate. I can write QWP, quarter wave plate. The role of the quarter wave plate is that it creates path difference in incident wave is lambda by 4. The path difference created in incident wave is lambda by 4. So that's why we say it's a quarter wave plate. So if the path difference is lambda by 4, I am writing the path difference, delta is lambda by 4. So what will be the phase difference? So the phase difference is, I am writing by delta, the phase difference is 2 pi upon lambda multiplied path difference. This is the phase angle. So if we substitute this value lambda by 4 in this equation, then is 2 pi upon lambda into lambda by 4. So this is pi by 2. That means the phase difference created by quarter wave plate is pi by 2, 90. While the path difference of the quarter wave plate is lambda by 4. One more important point is that it is a thin plate. Basically, quarter wave plate is very thin and it's again based on the double reflection technique. And the optical axis is parallel to its refracting faces. So, suppose if I consider, this is my quarter wave plate. So the optical axis is parallel. This optical axis is parallel to the incident wave, and it's based on a double refract technique. So this is the quarter wave plate. One more is the half wave plate. Half wave plate, or we can write HWP, small l is HWP half wave plate. In this plate, path difference is maintained by the range of lambda by 2. This is the path difference of a half wave plate. So if lambda gain is lambda by 2, then phase difference will be 2 pi upon lambda multiplying path difference is equal to 2 pi upon lambda multiplying lambda by 2. So this is the pi. So we remember that the phase difference of a half wave plate is pi, while the phase of a quarter wave plate is pi by 2. This is the one difference. One more. Now we find the thickness of a quarter wave plate and the thickness of a half wave plate if we know the refractive index of an E ray and O ray. So let's start the thickness of a quarter wave plate. So quarter wave plate QWP. If the refractive index of E ray is mu E and O ray refractive index is mu O, then mu E minus mu O, that means the difference of a refractive index of an E ray and O ray multiplying the thickness D will be equal to the path difference created by quarter wave plate. So in a quarter wave plate the path difference is lambda by 4, right? Therefore the distance thickness will be D will be lambda by 4 mu E minus mu naught. So this is the thickness of a quarter wave plate. This is the thickness of a quarter wave plate. So if we have the value of mu E, mu naught, lambda, then we can calculate the thickness of a quarter wave plate. Next, the thickness of a half wave plate. Of a half wave plate. So again we know that the path difference of a half wave plate is lambda by 2. Path difference is lambda by 2. Then mu E minus mu naught, that is the difference of the refractive index of E ray and O ray multiplied by the thickness of the half wave plate will be equal to lambda by 2. Therefore D is equal to mu naught. This is the thickness of a half wave plate. This is labeled as the thickness of a half wave plate. Okay, so we discussed about the Nicol plates and wave plates, quarter wave plates and half wave plates. Next topic is production and detection of electrically and circularly polarized light. We already discussed the electrically polarized light and circularly polarized light. The difference between the electrically and circular polarized light is that the phase difference are same in both the cases, that is the 90, but the magnitude of electric component are not equal in electrically polarized light, magnitudes are equal in a circularly polarized light. This is the one difference. The phase difference is always 90. So now we discuss production and detection of electrically and circularly polarized light. So first we take electrically polarized light. So the first one is the production of electrically polarized light. and then next we will be deduct the polarized, electrically polarized light. So the first step is, now first I draw the diagram. Like this is the unpolarized light. This unpolarized light incident. On a quarter wave length. So the outcome will be electrically polarized light, electrically polarized light. So the steps are as follow. Step first, number first, unpolarized light. Light incident on quarter wave plate, quarter wave plate means path difference is lambda by 4. If path difference is lambda by 4, phase distance will be pi by 2. Gain will be pi by 2. Right? So when unpolarized light is incident on quarter wave plate, if the second is, this quarter wave plate, this quarter wave plate split incoming wave into two parts. It split into the two parts. Why it splits? Due to the double diffraction phenomena. So it is split into the two parts. One is E sin theta and another is E cos theta. One is E sin theta, another is E cos theta. This step third. When these two parts superimpose or overlap, it produces electrically polarized light. At the end of quarter wave plate. So this is the electrically polarized light. So this is the technique by which we can convert unpolarized light into the electrically polarized light. Now, how we can confirm that it is the pure electrically polarized light? So the next is deduction of electrically polarized light. So the next is detection of electrically polarized light. So now with that thing, so we take again a same material, that is a quarter wave plate. Or you can take any calcite crystal quarter wave plates. Here you can take a calcite crystal of quarter wave plates and you rotate it. You rotate around this polarized light. If the intensity of this light became maximum, then minimum, again maximum, then minimum, but nevertheless zero, we can say it's pure electrically polarized light. Because it is, sometimes the radius is less, sometimes it's high. When the radius is less, we say the intensity is minimum. When the radius is high, we say that the intensity is maximum, but intensity will never be zero. So this is the characteristic of a pure electrically polarized light. So we can test by using this calcite crystal or Nicol crystal or any quarter wave plate. The last is production and detection of circularly polarized light. So again we draw a diagram. It's an unpolarized light. Light, it's incident on quarter wave plates. Incident on the quarter wave plate. And finally we observe a circularly polarized light at a specific condition. The condition is important, circularly polarized light. Now this angle is theta. So the steps for finding the circularly polarized light are as follow. Step 1. Number 1. Unpolarized light is incident on quarter wave plates. Unpolarized light incident on quarter wave plate, which path difference is lambda by 2 and the phase difference is pi by 2. It's incident on a quarter wave plate. QW3, quarter wave plate. It's the second. We rotate the quarter wave plate. Previously, we do not rotate the quarter wave plate in a electrically polarized light, but now we rotate the quarter wave plate in such a manner that it creates at an angle of 45 degrees between the incoming ray and the axis of quarter wave plate. So in the second, rotate quarter wave plate for an angle of 45 degrees. So we rotate it. Now the role of the quarter wave plate starts. It again splits ordinary light into the two parts. It splits quarter wave plate, splits light into two parts. That is E sine 45 degree and E sine 45 degree. Right? So we have the two components, E sine 45 and E cos 45. Sorry, E cos 45. Cos 45. So in outermost channel, where they superimpose, it produces circularly polarized line. Here the circularly polarized line. So the step third is, when these two rays are superimposed or overlap, it produces circularly polarized light. It produces the circularly polarized light. This is the circularly polarized light. Now we detect if it is a circularly polarized light or electrically polarized light. So again we take a calcite crystal here. Calcite crystal. And we rotate this calcite crystal around this produced polarized light. So now we rotate this calcite crystal around this polarized light. So the detection is so if we rotate this calcite crystal around this polarized light, the intensity will never change by rotating of this calcite crystal that means intensity everywhere remain constant. Everywhere the intensity remain constant. Intensity remain constant everywhere. And this is the property of a circularly polarized light, because in circle everywhere the radius is common. So the same thing, the intensity everywhere, we observe the same kind of intensity. So we can confirmly say that it is circularly polarized light. So these are the techniques by which we can produce elliptically and circularly polarized light, and we can detect elliptically as well as the circularly polarized light. So here I stop. We cover the whole polarization topic. Very first, I give an introduction about the polarizations, then the different techniques of finding of the polarizations, the light, then how we can detect by using the quarter wave plates, we detect circularly polarized light as well as the electrically polarized light. Thank you.